The more common term of value is blending. This one you probably already know. It's when we take our pencil and we use the side of it to create seamless value or gradation, which means that we are barely transitioning from black to white. Here's how we do it. When working with blending, we want to make sure that we are going in a seamless direction. You can go in small circles, it's my preference, but we are creating soft blends by starting with light pressure. You can always build up your pressure, but it is very hard to decrease the pressure. So, we want to go in small circles, covering the whole surface. We want to create a seamless colored pencil gathering. We want it to be able to become transitionless. I'm going back over it, adding another layer, moving with small rotations, small marks. I'm not going to come back into this area again unless I'm smoothing it out. This is a colored pencil. One way we can smooth out colored pencils is using Vaseline or even rubbing alcohol, which I'll show you momentarily. You do not have to use other materials to make this effect occur. You simply have to layer up your pencil. This project, I simply want to see you trying the techniques and layering up the pencil marks so that you can practice creating value. Blending. Seamless transition from light to dark. No major breaks, no big strokes. Blending. Cross-hatching is using lines that intersect to create value. Again, I'm going to use a spherical shape to illustrate this process. When I'm working in my spherical shape, I'm using lines that are parallel with each other and then crisscross. To create darker values, those crisscrosses will become closer together. Letting the lines intersect. To create lighter values, they will become farther apart. Alright, let's begin. I always take my crisscrossing lines and I let them form into the shape that I am shading. It's a sphere, so I want it to be curved in shape. My tripod keeps getting in the way. Again, this technique can be created using a pencil, an ink pen, or even colored pencils. You can even use crayons. The whole purpose of it is to keep getting lighter as we go, so the closer that the lines are together, the darker it will appear. The farther apart they are, the lighter it will appear. Cross-hatching. Hatching. Using lines to create value. These lines should not intersect. Unlike hatching or cross-hatching, where we had lines that crisscross, we're not doing that here. Here we're only going to have lines that come like this. They're never going to touch. The closer they are together, the darker our value will appear. We never want to create T's. So for this drawing, I'm going to create another sphere for you. And I'm getting awfully close to my tripod. I apologize. I'll scoot it out. All right. So for this, I'm going to create, just like in crosshatching, lines that follow the contour of my object. The closer they are together, the darker that your shadows will appear. The farther apart they are, the lighter they will appear. Be careful not to crisscross your lines. You want this to just be done with hatch marks, which are just tiny, tiny lines. The smaller your line becomes, sometimes the easier it is to work with. So I'm going to start layering up my lines down here and along the sides. I'm going to start by drawing a circle shape. I'm using an ink pen, that way you can see how the pencil works. I'm taking and I'm using small strokes and keeping these strokes very close together to allow them to become my darker surfaces for my sphere. Now I'm going to start to make them bigger as they come out. This is a lot like our cross hatching. The closer, the more layered up they are, the darker it will become. The farther apart they are, the lighter the area will become. I'm going to build up some area here. It's like scribbling with a purpose. The closer the marks are together, the darker it will appear in its value. Stippling. In this video, I'm showing you stippling, which is using dots to create value. Again, I'm creating a circle. Again, just like in scumbling and hatching and cross-hatching, the closer that my dots are together, the darker my dots will be. The farther and more spaced out they are, the lighter it will be. You can achieve this with pencil, with colored pencil, with crayon, with marker, even with paint. All you're doing is moving your tool in a dotting motion and covering your surface with dots. Notice right now all it looks like is pepper on the paper. It's not, it's an ink pen. I'm gonna slowly build up the pepper, the little dots, by moving them closer together. All I'm doing is tapping my utensil on the table. The more I layer it, the closer they get together, the more value will become. I'm not drawing circles, I'm just poking the paper. Stippling takes time. If you're running short on time with your project, you might want to choose a small area if you get stuck doing the stippling. The nice part about stippling is it's pretty forgiving. You can always add layers to make it darker. It's harder to add layers to make it lighter. Keep that in mind when creating value always. Stippling. Ombre, two colors fade together. During this demonstration, I'm going to illustrate for you how two colors will fade together. I have blue and I have green. To show you their colors, I will show you right here. Blue. You will apply pressure with the green pencil or whatever color, your first color, until you can start to see it fading up, pressing lighter and lighter as you approach the exiting point of the color. Notice how it's getting lighter. You come back over and blend in the darker spots. I'm going to take the blue pencil and I'm going to go the opposite direction, doing the same as what I did with the green, but reversing into the This allows two colors to merge seamlessly together, known as ombre.